Let's take a look to our Audit Trail Management. That's our newest solution and is not released yet. I'm working now since more than 12 years with Corporate Modeler, and since this time the topic of having a consistent change record was relevant for most of my project and clients. Now, the ATM is focusing on two user groups exactly fulfilling this audit trail requirement. First of all, the administrator. The administrator is the one who is setting up the audit trail, and it's very important that setting up the audit trail means you have no impact on your modeling performance, because ATM is a server-based application and it's not impacting modeling at all. The administrator has also the certainty that all changes like create, update, delete are recorded within the database. All locked information are protected against manual changes. So that means no user, no corporate modeler user or other user has access to these records. Then the second role that we have in mind are the auditors, for example. They can actually access a completely locked report with all the create, update, delete changes in the repository. There's a very clear structured log file showing old and new value for each property. It's very easy to use the embedded reporting to group, filter, sort the audit log according to your needs or requirements. For security reasons, we have also created a separate auditing schema, so that guarantees top secure and read-only access to the audit information in order to make sure no one can manually edit and change the audit records. So the ATM, as I mentioned before, is not available yet, but it will be made public available in Q1 2013. So now let's take a look to the administration view. As it is a server-side implementation, it means the administrator needs to have access to the SQL server, and we're using Common Language Runtime or CLR in order to improve the performance dramatically. So that's a very big difference if you use, for example, transactional SQL or the Common Language Runtime. Big performance improvement, and therefore you have no impact on your modeling environment. On the right hand side, you see a couple of scripts from our development, and there is a simple select top 5 from statement, and that's actually the way how you can access directly from the SQL server and see what are the records looks like with old and new value. It's highly secure because we have a separate ATM data schema, and you can see it in the red highlighting area. That means no corporate modeler user or other SQL user who is not specifically assigned to this schema will have access to your audit information. Very important. You have one single log table like the ATM change, and only accessible by the SQL DB owner or system administrator on the SQL server, of course. You have the flexibility in what type of user information should be logged, like logging for the corporate modeler username, the Windows username, or maybe the Active Directory name. Another advantage is the unified model structure. It reduces the complexity of the meta model. So it's everything in one simple log table. You have all the information of all object types, properties, everything stored in one single table. So you don't need to know how complex you have defined the meta model. What is the intersection object, which object types, and so on. So it's all in a unified model structure accessible. We've also created various read logs procedures to give other people access to the data of the log table. Again, it's just read-only, and you can specifically design who should have access to these read logs. People who have access to the read logs can then start either again on the SQL server or via any BI tool and can execute these read log procedures in order to get specific data out of the log file. Again, very important, just read-only. So let's take a different view, the ATM from an auditor perspective. They will see a very clean, easy to use web interface with flexible predefined views. So they can actually audit very easily content, user data, meta model. These views are very flexible. They can filter and group directly within this user interface. They can use paging, scrolling. The views can be hierarchically nested. And they can even export it to Excel and Word, for example. On top, the audit user has also the capability of accessing these read logs, so they can create any reports they like using their own BI tool. Currently, the audit trail management is in a beta stage, and it will be made public available, as I mentioned before, in Q1 of 2013. I would assume in February. But if you have any questions or if you're interested in testing this solution, please let me know, send me an email, or pre-subscribe at our website audittrailmanagement.com.